Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Saluki Football.
Let's go! Get up! Showtime, baby! Let's go!
Thanks for calling Saluki Athletics. Have a good day. Thanks. Bye.
They were leaders. Pioneers. Record holders.
Long jumper by Garrett. Look out.
Hall of Famers. Champions.
Steal by Fraser. Look out for him.
And today, we welcome them home. Please welcome back to the SIU Arena, the Jack Hartman era Salukis.
to Saluki football.
Handed off to Walker, cut back 15 to the 10. Mike score, does score, left side, touchdown. Lucian Walker gets the first touchdown in Saluki Stadium. Handoff, Harris gets left, got a block and a walk in, touchdown SIU. Pressured, steps up, has time, sideline open, Harris caught it 20, 15, 10, might get to the end zone, does, touchdown.
See all these lights, they're glowing, hear all these people cheer, feel all the love that's flowing, all just because I'm here. Get up and on your feet, get your hands up in the air, what you know about taking this way down, what you know hands in the air.
Speaker with a snap, handoff to Walker, bounces off left edge, breaks the tackle at the five, headed for the end zone. It's.
Hey, Saluki Nation, what's up? This right here is where I get all my gear. Come in the morning, Mike's got my towel ready for me, all my different workout gear that I'm gonna need for the day. Take it in there, get ready to get to work. All right, Reef and I are gonna take you guys upstairs now, coach's office, team meeting rooms, our lovely secretaries, the film rooms. So let's go check that out. Right here, pretty spectacular view of kind of what we get to see every day coming up here. Get the stadium up here, practice fields. This is a pretty cool place to stand on game day when all the people are around hanging out down there. Kind of gets you hyped for this game, so. We'll go check out the auditorium. So this is where we do all our team meetings.
Special teams.
Yep. Sometimes we get in here early, they'll throw a game on the big screen. We'll get to hang out and watch it. Probably the coolest remote that I've ever seen. Yeah, that's how you know you made it right there. That's big time. So projector, you know, can come down and go up. We got the computer set up here. Big projection room. You can see it about 110, 115 people in here. Yep. Make sure you're on time. Make sure you're on time. You're not on time.
The doors are locked.
You try to get in. Coastland opens them. Some harsh words. Always, yep. Those rookies struggle with getting here on time sometimes. This is our lovely student worker. Our lovely student worker, as you can see, working real hard, doing some math homework. About to be a teacher, right? That's right. So she's getting her math homework in, math teacher of all things. So when you first come in, this is what you see. She can kind of direct you around if you don't know where you're going. And obviously this right here is what we're talking about, the 2009 Missouri Valley Conference Championship. Right here, just kind of the meeting rooms where we kind of hang out right before we got to go into meetings or before we got some stuff to do. Obviously, again, you got the big TV. and then right here, pretty cool graphic of Brandon Jordan and Brandon Williams from 08, I think. So cool stuff like that just kind of makes us special, makes us home. So
Lee, Daisy Kareem. As you can see, you know, they got a picture of him running. It was the 2009 season. It was a good season for him. Now he's with the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Draft pick for us.
Sixth round, doing big things. Trying to get there just like he did. It's the Green.
It's the legend, SIU legend. We're going to go check out Coach Lennon's office right now. The boss man right here doing some work. How you doing today, Coach?
Yeah, I've been doing good. Yourself?
Doing all right. These guys are hard at work all off season for us, putting together game plans, scouting, recruiting tapes, just to get us ready to go for the season.
It's halftime between SIU and Youngstown State, and it's time for the Saluki Halftime Spotlight, presented by Walker's Bluff.
Here we go, take a charge. Here we go, let's go. Ball, 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 ball!
You know, I told our guys that at 5:30 today, there's a train taking off, and we want everybody on board. And not only do I need to say that to our players, but I need to say it to our fans. We know exactly what everybody thinks that we're supposed to do next year. I mean, it's been well documented. Out of 10 teams, we're most likely going to be voted 10th in the league. And do I believe that? Absolutely not. I've always had this philosophy, and I believe it. I've always been taught you're only as good as your seniors. And a head coach or an offensive coordinator for a football team or someone that's working is only as good as their quarterback, their point guard, or their point person. He's our quarterback. And he's got to be vocal for us, but he's got to lead by example not only on the floor but off the floor. I hope they're intense, high energy, quick, and not a lot of standing, a lot of movement, a lot of working, and a lot of teaching. And in this time of year, you teach an enormous amount. I mean, this time of year, it's all about teaching, and it's all about attitude, it's all about effort. Matter of fact, I've been coaching for 32 years. Even as an assistant coach, I was able to convey this to the head coach wherever we work. But for 32 years, our thought for the day to start the first practice off has been the same 32 seasons in a row.
Your performance is a reflection of your attitude.
Your performance is a reflection of your attitude. Everything comes from the inside. I told our guards, our success depends on the success of our bigs. Our bigs depends on the success of our guards, but everything we do offensively has got to start from the inside. Well, we deserve to have skeptics. I mean, we deserve to have skeptics. We can't run and hide from that. You look at paper, you look at what we've done over the last few years, you look where we're ranked right now, and so I don't have one problem with the skeptics. This is the only thing I can tell them. You want to judge me, you want to judge this program, you want to judge our players, come watch us now. I've been a head coach for 11 years, and the one thing that always was said about our basketball teams was that we played our tails off. And I hope people will be able to say that starting October 27th when we do our first exhibition game.
This has been the Saluki Halftime Spotlight, presented by Walker's Bluff.